North Korea attacks, America prepares for Thanksgiving, and what has this country become? Hey guys, this is November 23rd, 2010. My name is Reginald. I'm also known as Dimcat. What has this country become? Think about that. But first, I want to talk about retail. According to the National Retail Federation, there's actually going to be an increase of over 4 million people participating in the Thanksgiving holiday weekend shopping period. This Thanksgiving weekend, there's going to be 138 million consumers shopping, hitting the stores. Wow. Does this mean that there's more people with money? Does this mean that there's more economic activity? Maybe. But the unemployment numbers haven't really improved much. Blackwater. I'm sure you're familiar with their atrocities in Iraq and across the world. It's basically a mercenary company. Oh, I'm sorry. A private military contract company. They're private military contractors, not mercenaries. Ah, yeah. They consist of ex-soldiers who are paid to do military security projects. Clue! Metal Gear Solid is actually a video game where war, it takes place in the future, and it's a future where war has become a business. That's all I'm going to say. That's where I think this country is going. The Naked Truth. Now, this guy's from the UK, and it's an opinion piece. The Naked Truth. The TSA can touch my junk anytime. Oh, really? The pathetic whining over TSA's airport security is a naked attempt to smuggle on board an unsafe right-wing ideology. Oh, really? I didn't know that only right-wingers didn't want strangers putting their hands down their pants. Who knew? Quote, of course, if security is loosened, even marginally, and God forbid a terrorist should later succeed in taking down a plane, you mean a Al-Qaeda operative, then you could bet many of those Fox News commentators currently berating the TSA for being overzealous will be attacking the government for being weak on national security. As sure as the night that falls, day. Okay. More scared tactics. This isn't the only thing I've seen. This is just like the most extreme one I've seen, where people are saying, oh yeah, you can touch my junk anytime. And okay, it's a right-wing movement. This is stupidity. But the stupidity doesn't end there. Right here in America, a woman who told Obama she was exhausted loses her job. Well, Obama appeared at one of his town hall meetings, and this lady, I think she was an older black woman, I'm not quite sure. Yeah, I think she was. Verma Hart. I'm trying to remember who she was and what she looked like. She was a chief financial officer, and she worked at a veteran services organization in Maryland. And anyway, she told Obama that she was exhausted from defending him and his economic policies. And she was still waiting on the change that she voted for, essentially. Well, I'm sorry. Anyway, I'm laughing because what she says next, it makes no sense. She says that she's exhausted, but anyway, she lost her job recently, and she had an interview with some organization, I believe it's CNN, I'm not quite sure. She said that the recession was taking a toll on her and her family, and left her and her husband worried about her finances. She said that to Obama, whatever, when she said she was exhausted. At the time, she said, quote, and frankly, Mr. President, I need you to answer this honestly. And I mean, let's just stop there, okay? First of all, why do you need to ask somebody to answer something honestly if you're convinced that person is really going to answer honestly? I mean, the only time you say, well, I need you to answer this honestly is when you're talking to somebody who has been lying to you on a regular basis. I mean, just think about some of the things that come out of people's mouths. I wonder if she's even thinking about what's coming out of her mouth. This woman's 60-something years old. I think she's 50-something. I'm not quite sure. She's around probably 60 or something years old. But just think about it. And quite frankly, Mr. President, I need you to answer this honestly. So subconsciously, she knows that he's been lying his ass off a lot. Then she says, is this my new reality? Yes, this is your new reality. Okay. Anyway, she loses her job, which is unfortunate. She says that she told CNBC that she still supports Obama and noted that the economy was improving. Oh, wow. 4 million new shoppers. Though she finds the prospect of unemployment scary. Oh, really? If the economy is improving, then why are you so scared of unemployment? You know, things are improving. If the economy is getting better, why are you scared then? I mean, it's amazing how irrational people have become. Anyway, TSA Pat-down leaves Michigan man covered in urine. This is from Yahoo News. No, I'm not making this up. A bladder cancer survivor from Michigan who wears a bag that collects his urine said the head of TSA called to apologize for an airport pat-down that caused the bag to spill its contents on his clothing. Oh. Tom Sawyer, 61-year-old, retired special education teacher. Oh, wow. He said that he was in tears before he caught a flight to Orlando, Florida, on November the 7th. Quote, I was absolutely humiliated. I couldn't even speak. That's what he told MSNBC. Yeah. The TSA chief called to apologize, and he accepted. Proud to be in America, huh? This is what the country has become. U.S. to spend $413 billion more dollars on Afghan war. Thanks to a decision made by the President of the United States, Barack Obama, who misled people to believe that, oh, we're going to leave Afghanistan in July 2011. Ah, sure. Yeah. Americans will be in Afghanistan beyond 2014. So what has this country become, and would you be proud to say you're living in it if you're overseas? Thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. Have a good day, and remember the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.